Good morning, class 7. This is our 7th class. Class 7, 7th class. Okay, nice one. So, in our last class, we have talked about transfer of heat, and we have seen the two main mode of transfer of heat, that is the conduction and convection. And today we are supposed to continue our discussion with the radiation. But before starting the last mode of transfer of heat, let us solve few of the mystery of the everyday practice. Okay, for that let me ask you one question, that why do we wear woolen clothes in winter? So why do we prefer woolen clothes in winter, or we wear woolen clothes in winter? And in the similar way, I will also tell you in my now also, in case of while discussing radiation, I'd like to solve the mystery that why do we prefer white clothes or the light color clothes in summer. But that is only we can solve that mystery when we will discuss the radiation. Okay, so before that, what concept we have developed, based on that we can solve these two questions, that why do we wear woolen clothes in winter, and one more is that can you guess that one thick blanket, once again I'm repeating, one thick blanket or two thin blankets joined together, which will give you more comfort in winter? So one thick blanket or two thin blankets joined together. So let us see. So let us write down the first one. Why do we wear woolen clothes in winter? Why do we wear woolen clothes in winter? So for that you write down, what will be the answer? Wool. Have you seen your sweaters, how they, after folding, a floppy nature can be felt from them? So why, or even a reel of wool, even a reel of wool, if you will compress it, you will feel the floppiness inside it. So how does this floppiness exist in wool? You will see that one woolen thread is made up of more number of strands of wool, and they are twisted together. So because of that, it traps, it is capable of trapping a good amount of air in it, and we all know that air is a poor conductor of heat. So that's why woolen clothes can trap a good amount of air in the gaps of the fiber, and hence they act as a poor conductor of heat. So it does not allow the body heat to go outside and equalize with the atmosphere. That's why it traps, it creates a seal to the body heat. So it traps the body heat within the sweater to our body and helps us to remain warm in winter season. So how can we write the answer? For that, write it down. Wool is a poor conductor of heat since wool is a poor conductor of heat. Because it can trap, because it can trap air in the gaps of fiber. It can trap the air in the gaps of fiber and, or you can put the full stop. Since air is a poor conductor of heat, so wool helps us to remain warm in winter. By restricting the flow, of heat from our body to the surrounding. Okay, so here the answer N. So why do we wear woolen clothes in winter? We wear woolen clothes in winter because, what do you have written? Because wool is a poor conductor of heat, as because it can trap air in the gaps of the fiber. It can trap air in the gaps of the fiber. Since air is a poor conductor of heat, so wool helps us to remain warm in winter by restricting the flow of heat from our body to the surrounding. You can also write to the cold surrounding. Okay? Now, let us come to the next question. These are some extra questions. So what was our next question? That one thick blanket or two thin blankets? One thick blanket or two thin blankets within bracket you write joined together one thick blanket or two thin blankets joined together will keep us more warm, will keep us more warm in winter. So what do you think? One thick or two thin blankets joined together? Think of the previous question's concept, that woolen clothes have the capacity of trapping the fiber in their trapping the air in the gaps of their fiber. So now if by any means we can increase the trap of air in the blanket, then that will create a better shield. So in place of one thick blanket will have few gaps in its fiber, but two thin blankets will have not only gaps in their fibers where the air can be trapped, but also between the two blankets a film of air will be trapped, and hence two thin blankets will act as a good shield to the winter season. So that's why what we can write in winter, the two thin blankets will keep us more warm. So write down, in winter, two thin blankets joined together will keep us more warm compared to one thick blanket, one thick blanket, because along with the gaps in the fiber of the blanket, a thin film of layer of air will also be trapped between the two blankets. Okay, and thus the rest answer is same. Air is a poor conductor of heat, so it will help us to remain warm. So once again, in winter, two thin blankets joined together will keep us more warm compared to one thick blanket, because along with the gaps in the fiber of the blanket, a thin layer of air will also be trapped between the two blankets, which will create a shield to our body temperature. Okay, now the next thing is that one more question related to these two questions are related to conduction. Now here I will give you one more question which is related to convection, that why water can transfer heat by convection in upward direction only. So you have seen in convection a circulation of the warm water and cold water continues until and unless the entire water becomes hot. So why does the hot water always rise up? So the answer is that when water molecules near to the heat source absorbs the heat, what happens? Expansion takes place. So water molecules becomes a little bit expands a little, and when a material expands it becomes lighter, and that's why it goes up and its density becomes low. So when because the mass is not changing, so what happens? The mass is not changing, but the volume is increasing. Here, for a note, you can keep this thing in your mind. What is density? You have seen that when you pour some oil in the kadhai and you heat the kadhai, after some time the oil spreads. Why does this happen? Because with the heat, with the application of heat, the density, the material becomes, it expands. When you will apply heat, it will expand a little bit. So when this expansion takes place, then its density lowers down. Then its density lowers down. And what is density? So this is note. This is extra. This is not in your syllabus or in this chapter right now. So density is nothing but mass per unit volume. So the mass is not increasing. That is not increasing. The mass of that liquid molecule is same. But because of expansion, the volume is increasing. So when the volume is increasing, the denominator is increasing. And when the denominator increases, then the result decreases. So with the expansion of the molecule or substance, the density lowers down. So that is the same thing what happens over there also. When water molecules near the heat source absorbs the heat, it expands and hence its density lowers down. So when its density becomes low, the hot water, so as its density becomes low above in a container, the water is becoming hot near the bottom. So when the water near the bottom is becoming hot, its density is lowering down, and that's why the water molecule becomes lighter. It will go up. Why does it goes up? Because the cold water molecule, which is above the hot water molecule, they are now respectively more dense. That means they are little bit heavier than this, so they will try to come down, they will try to settle down, and thus the hot water molecule, they will rise up to take that place, and in this way the circulation goes on. So hence the hot water molecule are higher compared to cold water, hence the hot water molecule are lighter compared to the cold water molecule. So hot water rises up and cold water sinks. That's why water can transfer heat in upward direction only by convection. So this is the reason that why does in convection the hot molecules always move up. So this you will find why, not only in case of water, in case of air also. If someone asks you that when the convection takes place in air, then also the same thing happens. The hot air moves up, as a result, to fill up the vacuum space, the cold air comes from surrounding, and thus the storm takes place. What is we are expecting right now? Okay. So don't worry, in our next chapter we will also discuss all those things. So for now, if you are willing to write this answer, for that please write down the question: why water can transfer heat by convection in upward direction? So how we will write the answer? So write it down. The water molecules near the heat source water absorbing after absorbing heat becomes lighter. Becomes lighter. After absorbing heat, expands. That was right. Expands. Expands. Density becomes low. As a result, the molecules, the hot water molecules become lighter, become lighter, become lighter and rises up, become lighter and rise up. That's why water or any fluid can transfer heat only in upward direction by convection. So the water molecules near the heat source after absorbing heat expand and its density become low. As a result, the hot water molecules become lighter and rise up. That's why water or any fluid can transfer heat only in upward direction by convection. Okay? So, these are the real life situation which can be explained with the basis of the concept we have developed. Okay? So, in our next class, we will proceed with the last section. Yes, surely the last section, that is the radiation and sea breeze and land breeze. Then all again we will try to solve few of the mystery of this world. Okay, so you keep on practicing and stay safe.